One love.
First point to Andrea Dragoman.
Flat. One love. Love two.
Well, this is the kind of start she would have wanted, Dragoman.
One,
how about
two.
That from Chen Suyu? On the back end, lovely to watch.
Three, one.
Nice start from both the players.
She's played Asian players 30 times prior to this. Andrea Dragoman has a 33% win rate.
Yeah, it's a good point that you bring up, Shares, because the style of play from the European versus the Asians is so different.
For all.
Asians are, you know, much more closer, faster. Europeans go slightly back. More court coverage from behind the table. So it's contrasting styles of play.
Yeah, I've got to say, that's lovely, by the way. I always find it fascinating to see regional variations in any sport, actually. And how
six,
that
four.
Developed to the, what you've said, what Asians are known for doing and what and how Europeans approach it as well. Her biggest scalp, by the way, Dragoman is beating world number 19, Patricia Solia.
7-4.
That was at the World Championships in Houston. So she has created upsets before.
Jinsu,
after a slightly slow start, has really surged ahead here. Is three at the moment, and Chen Suyu relatively comfortable. High toss serve for Dragoman.
9-5.
Missing
nine,
that one,
six.
Chen.
Yeah, seems like Andrea has just not been able to get into the rhythm so far. Mm. Just a lot of guessing.
7-9.
Shake of the head there from Chen Suyu.
Nice down the line forehand spin. Slightly always harder to hit down the line because the length of the table is shorter there.
10-8.
She saved the game point here, Andrea Dragoman. She was quite very comfortable earlier, Chen Suyu. Dragoman has come back into this. Wow, she's done brilliantly here to draw level.
Yeah, and it was such a beautiful backhand opening spin. It's just like a picture-perfect moment to be hitting that backhand. So much spin, And the sound of the contact was also just so pure.
Off the edge. She's now turned it around and got game point. Dragomon was trailing by four earlier.
How clean was that?
Six of the last eight have gone to Dragomon. There you go. That's what I was saying when she was trailing. And she's taken the first game.
10.
Oh, no. It was an edge. And she called it out.
Ah.
Yes.
It did look like it, didn't it?
11 all.
These are the tiny, tiny margins we work with in table tennis. 11 all. How frustrating for Dragomon. She's going to change it up here, the serve. Well, she's put herself back in contention again.
Yeah, lovely keeping the ball shot, not allowing Chen Siyu to get into her attack at all. It's power play from her. Smart play, rather.
Well, there's no mistaking it this time. Dragomon has taken the first game. Great start for her.
You have Elizabeth Samara, Daniela Dodien.
Love one.
One of the most successful European countries in world table tennis.
Well, Hoopy. Women fans will be happy so far.
Two love.
Chen Siyu isn't looking best pleased at the moment.
Three love.
You had a bravo there from Coach Filiman.
Love four.
Well, it's an incredible change in momentum here because Chen Siyu was dominating proceedings.
Five.
But now it is swung completely the other way. She finally gets her first point on the board here, Chen Siyu.
Let 5-1.
She's got a pretty decent record against European players, Chen Siyu.
6-1.
About 70%. Right now, though, it's under threat. That's more like it. And a little acknowledgement there that I'll just click the net. Fair bit going on around her neck area as well. Chen Siyu.
3-6.
Yeah, she's strapped there on the neck. Wonder what happened. We saw earlier in the day, talked about injuries.
Yeah, Lin Win Ru.
6-4.
That left arm of his heavily strapped up. She just actually kind of rubbed the back of her neck there, Chen Siyu. There you go.
Yeah, something happening on the upper back.
Actually, since you've traveled all over the world playing table tennis, something as innocuous as even going on a flight and just sleeping awkwardly, it must play into your mind because that has all these things have an effect on you, don't they?
Oh, for sure. And this is such a sensitive area because it's your upper back and connecting the shoulders. So your trapeze and your scapula all involved so much into playing the shots, right? So you got to be so careful and be so agile all the time.
Well, she's had that on. Since Macau, all that table tennis that was going on there, of course, there were a number of events in April. So it's obviously something that's been bugging her.
Yeah, but she's surely make a good comeback in this game.
Yeah.
She's down since 5 points, and now it's 7-7.
Drugovan is fairly unflappable at the moment. She's not showing too much. Even when she was down in that first game, then she came back to storm it.
8-all.
Both coaches being vocal.
Beautiful backhand, right on top of the ball. I love how low Andrea Dragoman is.
Nine all.
That was a beautiful serve, an excellent side spin, and be doing at that stage. So phenomenal. Look at that. The ball literally moved.
Yeah, across. You
turning
can see that.
Side.
Yeah, oh, there's a bit more emotion there from Dragoman. She's just wincing at that one.
Oh,
these are some
10.
Great serves, actually, from Chen Suyu, who's now got a game point of her own.
Look at that super slow-mo version. You could see the ball literally traveling from left to the right side. So much spin.
Do you know what? She's done it again. She saved game points here. She's done it in the previous one. She's done it again here.
Yeah, such excellent mental toughness from Andrea. Not giving up at all. Just brilliant court coverage right there, Shehzad.
Excellent from her. She's got a game point of her own now. Well, well, could she go into a 2-0 lead?
Well,
she saved it there.
Andrea.
She's had game points on both occasions, Neha, but not able to convert.
One love.
Yeah, just enormous pressure on Chen Suyu right now. Andrea Dragoman, I think, has just been so brilliant so far. Also so calm and composed, right?
One
it
low.
Seems like a poker face all the time.
Yeah,
I don't seem to understand what she's been thinking. Well, unlike there. And now it could start to appear because she's leading,
leading.
2-0. And there is some self-expectation and pressure that comes on to players when they are in lead.
Oh,
one,
wow.
Two.
Brilliant.
That.
Yeah, that step around. And then look at how deceptive that forehand was.
You just saw Jen kind of lean to her right for a second,
one,
right? And that's
two.
All you need. That just that shift in weight, and it's gone.
Yeah, table tennis players need very good vision and analysis of where to hit because the court is so small.
Right.
You have to react quickly and understand where to hit. So all sorts of vision has to be strong enough.
4-1.
Again, this is tremendous from Dragoman. Remember, she led like this in the second game, and then Chen Suyu battled back. There's only one way
five.
That was going to end. Dragoman is in full control here.
And we'll see, are we going towards an upset here?
Two, five.
Still very young, Andrea Dragoman, 22 years old.
Let
up against Chen Suyu, 29th in the world.
2-5.
The lead is four. Chen Suyu. She's going to leave herself a lot to do if she goes three down. 12 of the last 16 have gone Dragoman's way.
7-2.
Yeah, I've not seen a timeout yet. She's holding her,
yeah, her shoulder. She's rubbing it in the neck area. That's obviously troubling her.
2-8.
Yeah, it's a shake of the head every time now. This is huge here for Dragoman. The lead is now a whopping 7. There's 8 game points here for Andrea Dragoman to go 3 up. High toss serve, and that's a long one as well. Andrea. Brilliant from the Romanian to stay in this match. Has to win the next 3 in a row.
One love.
Love that's two. Better. 2 quick points for her.
Yeah, but still, it's a bit like climbing Mount Everest for her right now.
1-2.
And every point counts at this stage.
Yeah.
You cannot afford to make any unforced errors.
2-all.
Andrea Dragoman looking so strong and so confident. I'm simply loving her backhands here. If you hear the sound of the contact, it's just so pure.
2-3.
Yeah, this is a player, talking about Chen Suyu, who's beaten the likes of Duhoi Kim in the past, Sofia Polkanova, Kasumi Ishikawa, Feng Tianwei, Zheng Yijing. She looks a little exasperated there, Dragoman, and Neha alluded to this earlier, in that now she's probably in the unexpected position of being so dominant in this. She's only, in theory, 8 points away from a big upset. It's got to be playing on her mind, Neha, that she's... It's all shifted onto her now. She's now the favorite to go on and win this. That was not the position she came into this match with.
3-5.
Surely, and look at the points won on her own serve. 62%. Yeah. That's whooping right there.
Yeah, she's 3-6. Very, very dominant.
And Andrea has not had any win against a top 30 player so far in her career.
6-4.
So this could be her very first, if my understanding is right.
Yeah, the only player she's beaten was at the World Championships, Patricia Solia.
Oh, 7-4. Superb. That was just like, it's kind of like you can frame that moment so picture sick right there.
Bravo. 4-8.
Andrea Dragoman looking for an upset here at the Table Tennis World Championships in Durban.
Yeah, when she beat Solia, that was a 4-3. And right now, she's just 3 points away.
Absolutely brilliant. Look at the amount of effort exerted in that. She had to literally hop up. And there you go. The ball was slightly closer to the net. She did it so well.
Wow, she's must be having butterflies right now. But this will be another scalp for her, potentially. Just to add to it, clipping the net again. Well, Jun just trying to relieve that pressure. And look at those match points now she has in hand, Andrea Dragoman. Oh, she has done it. Not perhaps the way anyone would have wanted. It doesn't matter. Andrea Dragoman.